quite a short start straight here in Poland at the Poznan circuit. No sooner are the riders off the start line, they're already into a long sweeping right-handed turn one. Flip-flop left, right through the chicane and into another long right-hander. Then we hit this left, seems to go on forever. And then as we get out of there, the circuit straightens up briefly before tipping back over on the right side. Again through a slight chicane, short straight, and then through this 180 left. That's turn eight, takes us down a long straight, into a 180 right, that's turn nine. And then as we come out of here, out to the curb, and then again, gradually turning right before hitting the brakes quite hard, through the right, into the dirt section, immediately left, over a triple, and you see the turn there has three lines. Exit through a wave section, and at the end of the straight, we have a double jump. Nice heel clicker there from Mauno HERMUNEN. And then we go left, then right, back onto the asphalt section. And as we head back down this straight, through a long right-hander, this is the final turn on the racetrack. We're back on the start-finish track. That's a lap here at Poznan. Marc-Reiner Schmidt secured his fourth pole position of the season with Tony Clem and Diego Monticelli joining him on the front row. Giovanni Busai heads at row two from Vorlicek and Bartolini. It was dry in time training, but it's been wet over the night and it's continuing to drizzle. So we have a wet racetrack. The winner from race one was Tony Clem. Schmidt was second, Lapini third. And as we head into turn one in race two, Tony Clem heads everybody through that first turn as Luca Tiaglia runs wide there on the number 93 machine. Already though, the riders starting to peel their way through. Clem leads the way, Monticelli second, Martello third, Busai fourth, Schmidt down in fifth place on the number 41 machine. Heading through the tricky little chicanes here. Be careful not to catch the white lines in the curbs as we go on board here with Bartolini and Schmidt up the inside of Busai and into fourth place. Very treacherous conditions here. Look how close Bartolini was there onto the home straight then. And it's Clem, Monticelli, Martella, Schmidt now fourth, David Jimenez, the Spaniard, in fifth place. As they disappear around that long sweeping right-hander through the little kinks. A lot of water out on track. Monticelli down the inside of Clem for first place. Runs wide though. Clem back up the inside. Has Martella gone through as well? I think he might have done. Well, Martella going around the outside and then up the inside and... wow, this way could go anyway. But it's Monticelli, though, who does take the lead on that number 68 machine. He's got Clem behind him. In fact, that's Martella there now, second. Clem has been pushed back to third on that 111. And Monticelli trying to make a break for it as Clem down the inside of Martella for second position now. And then on the very left-hand side, 41, Schmidt, biding his time. Well, he started fourth, he's gone around Martella. Ooh, bit of a twitch there. It's third place, chasing Tony Clem, his main championship rival, the rider that took 3 points away from him in moto number one. So, this is the battle for the overall round win and also the points in a championship as well. And down the inside goes Tony Clem. So, Monticelli now second. Marc-Reiner Schmidt is third. Decent crowd here despite the weather conditions, but Marc-Reiner Schmidt there in third in the background. Oh, a bit of a twitch down a curve from Monticelli and, well, doesn't need a second invite, does he? Marc-Reiner Schmidt now up into second place going after Tony Clem. What a race this is turning out to be. S2, race two. Battle for the lead right here, and will we see a repeat maneuver? Well, not quite close enough. Oh, back end stepping out there from Reiner Schmidt as well. This is where he's been making his time. Hard on the brakes, down the inside of Clem, and takes the lead. So we do have a new race leader then. So Schmidt takes the lead from Clem. Clem looking semi-interested as well, though. There's Martella. And just behind him, Monticelli and Giovanni Busai in fifth place. Bartolini just off the back of this group, the 110. on the Honda in sixth. And look at that for a big slide there from Giovanni Busai. Having to use all of his past road race experience just to get him out of that one. On board here, Bartolini, as he looks to go past Monticelli. That takes him into fifth place. A good bit of riding there. So Martella then Busai, then Bartolini, then Monticelli just here, bringing up the rear. Battle down the straight here, and well, that's a little bit further down the order. Vlad Niega and Wojciech Manczak. As Alessandro Aznicar making his move. It's further down the order in 16th place, but Schmidt and Klem, though, still going at it at the head of the field. Here's Monticelli. He's in fourth place. Got Bartolini and Kevin Fagra, who crashed a 10th on lap 6, has done well to get back to challenge these guys for fourth place. Back with the lead group, though. 41. Schmidt and Klem. Which way is it going to go? Well, the flag goes out. And Marc-Reiner Schmidt takes victory in race 2 and the overall. Klem has to settle for second. Martella third in the race. And confirmation of those results. The overall then belongs to Schmidt, Klem second, and Monticelli third overall this weekend, round 4 in Poland. And there is your podium. Third overall, Diego Monticelli. Second overall, Tony Klem. Your overall winner for the fourth time this year, Marc-Reiner Schmidt. The perfect season coming to an end, though. Tony Klem beating him in the first race, but he makes up for here with the overall win. There's a red plate to signify he is still the championship leader.
On Saturday, on the dry condition, for me it was very easy. I find the speed, and with off-road, for me it's perfect. In the time practice, in 1 second before Tony Klem. But today, on the wet condition, for me it's not so easy. In the first race, I make a big crash in the second corner, and I'm the last one and go to the second place behind Tony. Okay, for this race and the second race I can win before Tony. I'm very happy for this one, and I hope next month I make the European Championship, and at the end of the year I go to World Championship.
So a great day then for Marc-Reiner Schmidt, and classification time. He still leads the championship. Klem still second, Monticelli third, Bartolini fourth, Giovanni Busai is fifth. Overnight rain on this Poznan circuit and constant drizzle throughout the morning here, leaving the circuit very, very wet indeed. So what was a very fast, dry circuit has turned into a very treacherous circuit. So the riders have been told that today, round 4, there will be no off-road section. Mauno HERMUNEN will start on pole, 0.8 of a second quicker than Thomas Scherer, with Lazzarini third. Row 2 is Teo Monticelli, Pavel Kamar and Max Verderosa. So the wet conditions then, how will they catch out these riders? Race 1, the lights go out, and into the first corner we go, and wasting no time getting to the front. Mauno HERMUNEN with Scherer second, Holeshot third, Lazzarini in fourth as Holeshot just hits a little bit of traction. Coming out of turn 3 then, on board with Holeshot, he's in third, he's got Scherer and HERMUNEN just ahead of him. Through the long sweeping left-hander, HERMUNEN, Scherer, Holeshot, Lazzarini, they top 4. As they find their way through the chicane into this next right-hander. Lots of overtaking opportunities through there as the race goes on, I'm sure. But these riders just trying to pick their way through at the moment. On board here with Holeshot, he's in third place, just behind Scherer. Look at the rain on the camera. These riders having to use roll-offs. But back here with the lead group. And on board once again with Holeshot. A great move around the outside of Scherer, down the inside of Mauno HERMUNEN. Runs wide. Oh, gets a bit of a wobble on as he comes out of there. Both riders going to pass him back, that's for sure, are they? No, he does it well. Ends up in second position, and it's Scherer who goes to the front, pushing HERMUNEN then from first to third. Holeshot stays in second after all of that. Now he's having another look at Charette. This time he goes through, takes the lead. So Holbacher and Hermanen around the outside of Charette, moves back into second. Charette being pushed back to third. Lazzarini is in fourth place. Devon Vermeulen in fifth. He just found a way past Asiri Kingelin, actually, to get himself up another position into fourth and challenging the lead group here. The rider from the Netherlands could have been the European champion last year, but that was the number 11 behind him, Asiri Kingelin. So Holbacher then feeling the pressure. There's Mauno Hermunen going through. Hermunen takes the lead. Holbacher now second. The four of Charere is in third. Remember, the battle for the championship lead is with the rider leading the race, but he makes a mistake. And Holbacher goes back through into the lead now. And Charere, from out of nowhere, finds his way through. So too does Hermunen. Hermunen has the inside line, pushes Holbacher wide. Lazzarini tries to sneak through. So too does Vermeulen. And Vermeulen losing out to Lazzarini and almost there to the number 11 of Kingelin. New race leader here then, Thomas Charere. Oh, and Holbacher down. So Holbacher, he goes out of third place. Look at it from this angle, just lost the front. Couldn't pick it up. Hermunen then, he's in second. Lazzarini third. Kingelin is fourth. Vermeulen 188 is fifth. Monticelli there, number 90. He's in sixth place. On board here with Holbacher. He's picked himself up, rejoined the race. He's in eighth at the moment. Well, Thomas Charere, he's obviously ran wide because he's now down in 11th position. Judging by the riders that have just gone through on him, Verderosa, Charere now finding his way past Sitnietski to get himself up the inside. Well, and Verderosa. So two passes there. Charere then back in ninth place. Oh, the yellow flag. Who's that for? Well, that was Kingelin. Kingelin then, he's also fallen from third. Back down the home straight. Hermunen, Lazzarini, and Vermeulen getting closer all the time there. So the top three riders on the same bit of racetrack here as we go back on board with Holbacher as he goes past Pedro Hita. That puts him into sixth place. There's your top three though. Hermunen, Lazzarini, and look how aggressive the 188 of Vermeulen is. Thinking about it down the inside. She's going to have to back out of that challenge for now. On board here once again with Holbacher as he pulls up behind Ravaglia. That gets him into fifth place. And Charere making progress further down the field as well. Finds himself in seventh. He's got Ravaglia just ahead of him in sixth place. Here's Lazzarini. And Vermeulen fighting over second position. And down the inside, Vermeulen finds his way through. Holds a tight line, doesn't get the drive down the back straight. And Lazzarini goes back up into second, but, well, Vermeulen not pulling out of that, goes through. A look from Lazzarini there, as if to say, come on, boy, calm down. And that's the reason why. Because Vermeulen loses a front through the next chicane. He goes down, picks himself up, keeps the engine going. Electric starts on KTM, so stays in third place. Lazzarini then, having a decent ride in that second place. There's a battle further down though for 10th, Verderosa and Kingelin. Kingelin goes through. Sitnietski just behind him in 12th. Pavel Kamar in 13th place, having a very quiet ride. Oh, and who's that? Petra Hita going out of 7th place. Handing the advantage then to Ilya Michalczyk. Oh, Michalczyk goes down just as he comes back onto the start straight. So he falls out of 7th place. So riders falling like flies here now. Just shows you how tough these conditions are here at this racetrack today. Well, there is Monticelli. He's in fourth. Holbacher closing in fifth position, though. Will he be able to do anything about him? The 72, he crashed from third. He's all over the back of Monticelli now. Surely just a matter of time. On board with Holbacher. Can he get close enough? Well, he's thinking about it. Down the start straight he goes. Will he be able to get out up the inside? He takes a tighter line, and he does go through to fourth place. So Monticelli then, number 90, gets pushed back into fifth. All on the final lap. Got his work cut out to try and hold on to that position, though. Hermunen back with the leader, 131. That's Kamar behind him. He's a lap down, but Hermunen on his way to victory. The flag goes out. Mauno Hermunen wins S1GP Race 1. What a race. All kinds happening here, but good points in the bag for Mauno HERMUNEN. Take a look how it finished then. HERMUNEN was your race winner. Lazzarini second, Demulin third, Holeshot fourth, Monticelli fifth. Thomas Chareyre could only manage sixth. Kingelin seventh, Ravaglia eighth, Kamar and Bodarosa your top 10.
It's amazing. When I think last season, I go two times in the World Championship and I have also good results. But the speed was sometimes not so good, and with some mistakes. We learned a lot last season, and now I win the Austrian Championship five times. And this year is the first time who don't start in the Austrian Championship. I only concentrate to the World Championship and German Championship. It was amazing in a race with the podium in both races. It was nice to fight with Lazzarini and not so far away from HERMUNEN and CHAREYRE. World Championship is mostly more speed, more faster, and the off-road is more technical, and for me it's a little bit different the first times on so fast tracks. I have to come 110% to make a pass, and I'm on the limit in this way. I'm very happy to have the final in my home, nearly my fans. It's also a very fast track. It's a long straight, long corners. Off-road is a long right corner, like flat track or speedway. And I think for a World Championship is very nice, because in Austria we have some interest in this. Husqvarna also look very big to this event. I know this track completely from the beginning to the end. I get five titles, Austrian champion on this track. I think we can improve more in my bikes and in my speed, but at the moment it's not so easy for time and money, but we make the best. And so it's a big thanks to my team and to my mechanic, to my family for this.
Lights go out then, start of S1GP Race 2, and once again from the outside, Mauno HERMUNEN sneaks into the lead. He's got Chareyre and Lazzarini right there though. Kamar fourth, Monticelli fifth, Vermeulen I think that was there in sixth position. So the Dutchman having a slightly different start this time around, but for sure, the way that he rode in Race 1, he'll be putting the hammer down and trying to get up the front as soon as possible. Bad start that time for 72, Lukas Holeshot way down the order. Lead group here though, as they were just a moment ago, but Vermeulen already making progress. He's up into fourth place now. Kamar is in fifth. So coming through then, Mauno HERMUNEN. Thomas Chareyre looking interested this time, just didn't feel comfortable in the wet conditions in Race 1, as Vermeulen charging down the inside of the former world champion, defending world champion. Look at that three abreast, Vermeulen, HERMUNEN and Chareyre, and the Dutchman, 188 for Vermeulen, goes through into the lead. Remember, he fell here in the first race, trying to find his way past Lazzarini, but already starting to make a break for it. Never led a World Championship race before the back end. Just a reminder as to how tricky these conditions are. On board here with Holeshot down the inside of Lazzarini, I think that was. In fact, it was Bertarossa, Lazzarini's teammate, so making progress then into ninth now. There's Asiri Kingelin just getting past there by number four, was even Lazzarini. So again, just like Race 1, these wet conditions, something of a leveler for the riders. HERMUNEN, Monticelli, and Chareyre. Back on board here, as Holeshot at the inside of Kamar, that's for seventh. But look at the lead that Vermeulen's got there. Monticelli now second, but for how much longer? Because HERMUNEN coming through up the inside. The Finnish rider then neatly down the inside of the Italian. Chareyre is fourth. in the blue and green, then Lazzarini, then the number 11 off the back of that group, Asiri Kingalin, but Monticelli not giving up the fight here. Tries to go down the inside of the TM rider, pushes him wide. He loses out and almost gets passed there by Thomas Chareyre, his main rival in the championship, but he knows he's got some points in hand after that victory in race one. But Chareyre this time does force himself down the inside, but then he pushes him wide and Lazzarini goes through. So Lazzarini, the main beneficiary there, and Chareyre being pushed back by Kingalin as well. So drama all over this racetrack then. Monticelli, Lazzarini, Hermanen, Kingalin, Chareyre as they go through turn one. There's Vermeulen, a mile out in front. Could he be picking up his first race win here as Monticelli, Lazzarini, Hermanen, 1-3-1. The red number plate on the front of that blue TM is fourth. Kingalin now fifth, Chareyre is sixth, and Hermanen looking to make a move down the inside of Lazzarini. Goes back into third place. Back down the home straight. He's all over the back of Monticelli, and just like he did a lap or so ago, finds himself back into second position. There's Mauno Hermanen. There's Ravaglia, a little bit further down the order. Some work to do as he battles there with Verderosa and Sitnianski over ninth place. Whoa, how tight is that? Lazzarini as we go back on board here. Holbacher in seventh. Got Chareyre just ahead of him. Chareyre, though, nudging up the inside of Kingalin for fourth place. Despite the weather, great onboard images. Through that first turn, there's Monticelli. Kingalin, Lazzarini, Holbacher down the inside of Lazzarini. That puts him into sixth place on the white Husqvarna. Back on board here with Holbacher. He's in sixth. Oh, Lazzarini neatly back down the inside, back into sixth position then. So Kingalin, he's third at the moment. Whoa, gets a little bit out of shape coming back onto the home straight more than once. And Monticelli back up into third place then. So Kingalin gets pushed back to fourth. Thomas Chareyre in fifth. Lazzarini is in sixth position. Holbacher still just off the back of this group in seventh. Still looking to make progress. Oh, Kingalin down the inside of Monticelli. Puts him third. The Italian takes a look over his shoulder. Coming under attack from Chareyre. But Lazzarini goes through on Chareyre. So Chareyre not getting to grips with these damp conditions here at all, and looking like he's about to, well, he is, gets passed there by Holbacher. So Holbacher then, seriously on the move, as is Lazzarini. And Holbacher. So Holbacher going through to fourth place. Back on board with Holbacher. Vermeulen, though, has a pretty sizable gap, but that's been whittled down here. Coming into the final lap, we're on the penultimate lap at the moment, but Mauno Hermanen has found his way back onto the rear wheel of Devon Vermeulen. He's going to swing down the inside, come out tighter as they come onto the start-finish straight. He takes the lead there from Vermeulen. Will Vermeulen respond here? Oh, he gets a little bit out of shape there. Is that going to cost him time? Hermanen would love to pick up a double victory here, but Vermeulen not going to make it easy for him. He dives down the inside. He takes the lead as they go into the final lap, and it's Vermeulen. He takes a nervous look over his shoulder, but look how close it is. Oh, too much front brake there from Vermeulen. Has to pull out of it. That might be the difference between winning and getting second in this race, because that gap now starting to open up on the final lap. Hermanen has pulled clear more than 10 bike lengths as he works his way towards the final turn once again. Vermeulen, though, what a great ride for him. Final turn then for Mauno Hermanen. And he exits the right-hander, takes the checkered flag. It's two wins out of two. He will extend his championship lead further over Thomas Chareyre. But what a great ride there from Devon Vermeulen. Confirmation then. Hermanen wins race two. Vermeulen second. Kingalin third. Lazzarini fourth. Holbacher, Chareyre, Monticelli, Kamar, Ravaglia, and Verderosa, your top 10. Overall, classification in the Grand Prix, Mauno Hermanen, Mr. Maximum today. Vermeulen second, Lazzarini third. Thomas Chareyre can only manage sixth, losing 20 points to his rival. So your podium then, third overall, Ivan Lazzarini. second overall, Steven Vermeulen, and your overall winner, Mauno HERMUNEN, as the riders take their trophies on the podium. Been a very vocal crowd here this weekend in Poznan, the first time that Supermoto World Championship and European Championship has been in this country. Mauno HERMUNEN with another winner's trophy for him and for TM, but the X-MAX rider under the watchful eye of Max Biaggi this year. Mauno HERMUNEN almost ready for taking the red plate, but he does so now. He still leads a championship.
It was a really good weekend for me. I came here and nobody didn't ride it here before, so I'm usually quite fast to learn the track, and happened Saturday when I was fastest in practices and time practice, and today won both races and couldn't be more happy. We've struggled a lot in the beginning of the season, but now everything seems to go my way, so it's really good feeling to have this and with a big gap now.
So world championship standings then look like this. Mauno HERMUNEN pulling well clear of Thomas Chareyre this weekend. Lazzarini though, just a few points behind in third. So good day for Lazzarini. And in the manufacturer standings, TM still clear. Maximum points for them this year. Honda second, Husqvarna third. KTM, Suzuki and Yamaha running out the top. That's all we've got time for here. Join us next time for more Supermoto World Championship action. My name's Paul Malin. Thanks for watching. We'll see you then. Bye for now.